Back in 2021, I wrote a blog post explaining the Money Flow Index and compared it to the venerable RSI. I used algowizard to manually program an MFI strategy to trade pullbacks on the pound dollar, but results were underwhelming. This time, I'm going to program the MFI into a Strategyquant custom template and run it through the genetic builder. Can we do better? Let's see. First things first, the MFI is essentially a volume-weighted RSI, meaning it uses tick volumes for decentralized markets. Like the commodity channel index, typical prices are used instead of closing prices. Money flow is defined as the product of typical price and volume. It is positive when typical price increases from one period to the next, and negative when typical price decreases. The money flow ratio is the sum of positive money flow divided by the sum of negative money flow. The default lookback is 14 periods. Finally, like the RSI, the MFI is normalized to values between 0 and 100 using this formula. Like most momentum oscillators, the MFI is most commonly used to identify overbought and oversold conditions. Levels above 80 indicate overbought conditions, while levels below 20 indicate oversold conditions. Another less common approach is to use the MFI as a coincident indicator, meaning it's used to confirm the current market direction. Levels above 80 could indicate an uptrend, while levels below 20 indicate a downtrend. I will experiment with both approaches, starting with the conventional approach, where I will go long when the MFI crosses above 20, indicating an exit from oversold conditions. For shorts, I want the MFI to cross below 80. I usually use stop orders for entry because I like some price confirmation, but market orders can work well too. The genetic builder will fill the random placeholders. Time to run the builder. By the way, this work isn't easy. How about some support, guys? Here's one decent performing strategy. In addition to the MFI condition, we want the close to be lower than the lowest high of the last 10 periods, for at least 4 bars. Trade management is a simple but generous 4 plus ATR stop loss and trailing stop. This simple combination works well for trending markets, where one outsized win can make up for a large number of small losses. Here's how a long trade looks, eventually hitting its trailing stop. Here's the equity curve and performance metrics. The 2.3 payout ratio is a consequence of the loose trade management. The trade-off is that you will have a lower win rate, which is not a problem unless you're selling your strategy to novice traders. I think the first condition looks for retracements or consolidations. I tried removing this condition, and the strategy becomes untradeable. The MFI crossing over condition confirms the exit of this pullback. Now let's try the MFI in its coincident form. The template is identical, except that for longs, we will now require the MFI to cross above 80 for longs and below 20 for shorts. Running it through the builder again, and here's another strategy. In this case, the upper line of the 20-period Keltner channel needs to be above yesterday's close for at least 7 bars. This is a roundabout way of looking for an uptrend, which the MFI confirms. Trade management is quite similar, except that a 39-bar time stop is added. Most of the time, when the market is either consolidating or in an uptrend, the Keltner channel condition is almost guaranteed to be satisfied. In a downtrend, however, this condition can prevent entries when a short-term impulse, like those encountered during news releases, causes the MFI to shoot above 80. Here the time stop closed the trade. A 10-year backtest as usual, with 375 trades. To check the usefulness of the Keltner channel condition, I removed it and redid the backtest. The number of trades more than doubles, but both the win rate and payout ratio drop, making the strategy far less appealing. That's two easy ways to use the MFI indicator. The key takeaway from this video is that indicators can be used in a myriad of ways to suit your purposes. There are no secret techniques, and there are no secret indicators. For more trend-following strategies, check the playlist at the top. If you're the mean reversion type, check out the playlist at the bottom.